Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today's project, we're going to be working on my 2016 Yamaha Wave Runner, the VXR series. It's a 1.8 liter four-cylinder motor, and it's got about 100 hours on here, so it's going to be due for some new spark plugs, and that's what we've got today. So I went down to my auto parts store and got the NGK LFR6A, and this is what's recommended by the manufacturer. So nice quality plug. So let's go over some of the items that you'll probably need to do this project. So you're going to want to have a Phillips head screwdriver, a 10 millimeter socket, a spark plug socket, this is a 5/8, and it's got a rubber insert inside, and that helps to grip the spark plug and extract it from the engine. If you don't have that kind of spark plug socket, then I have a magnetic pickup tool available so that you can pick up the spark plug and take it out that way. You're going to want an extension, at least maybe a 6-inch extension. Grab your ratchet, power ratchet, and you're going to need a torque wrench. These spark plugs are torqued down to 18.4 foot-pounds, and what I'm using is a smaller torque wrench that measures in inch-pounds. So it's an easy conversion. For every foot-pound, you just multiply it by 12. So we'll take 18.4, multiply it by 12, and roughly going to be at 220 inches. So we'll set this to 22-inch pounds, and this will be ready to go. It's not a whole lot of torque. You can over-torque these by hand pretty easy. You don't need to apply a whole lot of torque. Basically, you're just applying just enough to make this crush washer seal the engine block. And it doesn't take a whole lot of torque to do that. Another thing you'll want to have is some anti-seize lubricant. I like to put that on threads like these, just a small amount, just a thin layer. That'll just kind of help prevent the spark plug from binding in the motor. So if you don't have a big jar like that, you can just get small packets like this at the auto parts store. Easy to have, just enough if you just need enough for the job. And you also, I recommend to have some dielectric connector grease, and you'll apply a small amount of that to this top part of the spark plug. This is the part where the spark plug boot comes in, and it's going to help prevent, you know, water from getting up inside and corrosion and interfering with the spark plug. And then last but not least, you'll have a spark plug gap tool. These are gapped at about 0.8 to 0.9. They come from the store, usually pre-gapped, but you can double check and see if they're within clearance. And this one's pretty much right there. So these are just fine. And that's about it. That's about all you're going to need for this job. And so what we're going to do, I'm going to start by taking the seats off, and we'll get into the engine bay and get started. Okay, so here we are with the engine bay. So the first step is to get the engine cover off, so we'll just use our Phillips screwdriver to take these two bolts out to hold it in. There's one. Now sometimes corrosion can get to these too, so you might want to put a little something on these to get them to not stick so bad. I've had that happen before and they're hard to get out, because you don't want to round off the tops. That would happen to me one time. There we go. Okay, so these are the coil packs on top, so that's the next thing that we want to remove. And each coil pack is just held by two 10 millimeter bolts, so we'll take those out real quick. Thank you. Okay, and that's basically it. So this is a new Milwaukee tool that I got. It's their M12 series. It's the 3/8 inch drive power ratchet. The reason why I like this one is because of the head size is real small, so it can get into tight spaces if you need to. And it's their high speed version, so it really has a lot of RPMs to really take fasteners off really quick. So pretty nice ratchet. I like it. Okay, so now we'll just take each coil pack out and just set it to the side here. Okay, and now we'll go ahead and get our spark plug socket ready to go, and we'll take out each of the spark plugs. Okay, so now we're ready to install the new plugs. So I went ahead and put the anti-seize compound on the threads just to light them out. And I went ahead and put some grease on this part of the plug, so these were ready to go. So I'm going to get these started by hand, and then I'll get it to where it starts to give some resistance, and then I'll finish it with the There we go. So I'm not using a whole lot of pressure. Just, I barely got my thumb on it, pushing on it like that. So not a whole lot of torque is needed to get these things to seat correctly. Okay, that one's good. So those are all done. Now all we gotta do is put the coil pack spec on. Like I said, these don't have to be torqued down real hard, just snug. You don't want to crack the plastic. Okay, so now we're going to put the engine cover back on. We're almost done. There we go. So overall, this process is pretty straightforward, and it's going to be pretty similar to other personal watercraft that are built like this one have the coil on plug design. Just kind of look at your owner's manual to see what kind of plug is recommended and other torque specs and things like that. So that wraps up this project, guys. Thanks for stopping by. If you liked that video, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.